Get ready to match the stars. Dick Gaudier, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Fluth, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flay as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Reber.
How are they? Good. How are you? Look at who's here. Aren't you a beautiful bunch?
Oh, yes.
Thank you,
You're beautiful. You ready to play?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Well, shall we begin?
Sure.
Let's greet these two ladies, Cynthia Ingram and Gina Giampetro. Oh, all right. Now, here we are. Cynthia is our current champ. She's won a total of $600, and she's being challenged by Gina here. They've both had their first round questions, and at this moment, the score is 3-0 in favor of the challenger. You got your work cut out for you, haven't you?
I do, yes.
All right, we'll see how this game ends after we see about this. All right, here we go. Push the button, reveal our second round questions. Gina, you may have A or B.
B, please.
You want B? Okay. Here we go. She matched three people last time.
Who'd she match?
Well, she matched everybody in the upper tier. Last time.
They were saying they're the smart kids down there. And look who they matched. They matched all the so-called dummies up here.
That's right. They matched the dummies up there last time.
Yeah.
She did. And now this time, you know. Now, just in case you've ever wondered, you haven't, in what it looks like, in case you sit up on the second tier, this is all you see of me, you see. You ready? Here we go.
Just a second. Give me your glasses.
Don't wear glasses, no. No, no.
Oh, yeah. Would you like to do me one more time? Yes. Don't break them, sweetheart.
No, all right. Oh, you're going to be Brett.
I'll be Brett.
Oh. Wait, get all the glasses.
Yeah. Get your hands off my club soda.
Are you ready for the question?
Step out of your club soda. There's nothing I can
Are you going to be Charles,
bit.
Are you, Fanny? Okay.
What was the question you did?
Wait a minute. You ready?
Charles worked the stuff in this.
Georgie Porgy said.
Are we going to the motel later?
Yeah.
Don't worry, I must have a sip. Oh, that's good. 9 years. 9 years.
Here we go now. Georgie Porgy said, I kiss the girls and make them cry. And Horrible Hannah said, that's nothing. I kiss the boys and make them blink.
What was the question again?
Is there an operative word?
Will you start writing an answer?
I'm under pressure.
Come on, I'll write an answer.
I'll wait a minute.
Georgie Boyd said, I kiss the girls, make them cry. And Horrible Hannah said, that's nothing. I kiss the boys and make them blank.
My camera on.
Yes, your camera is on. All right, here we go. Gina. Georgie Porgy said, I kiss the girls and make them cry.
Wait a minute, wait a minute.
Wait. I want a little drinky poo.
Definitely you.
That taste, he says. All right. That's enough of that. Gina, are you ready? Okay. Georgie Porgy said, I kiss the girls and make them cry. And Horrible Hannah said, that's nothing. I kiss the boys and make them blank.
Run.
You ever heard the rhyme? Georgie Porgy? Little rhyme there? Okay, you ready? What do you say? I kiss the boys and make them...
That looks like Dick Gaudier.
It's tough being first, yes.
Faint.
Faint. That's not like it's the boys make them faint. Okay, what do you say, Brett?
What do you say, Brett?
Well, this doesn't make me look too masculine, does it? If the judges are really kind, I said throw up. Throw up.
Okay.
Is Chuck? She finished with her play?
Yeah. Come on, Charles, give us your answer. I kiss the boys.
As usual. the incorrect
That's
answer.
Die. No, die really was kind of the definitive answer there. Very good. Kiss the boys and make them die. Now,
kids are ahead.
Cynthia, my dear, you got a match 3 to tie, 4 to win. Who plays? Everybody plays.
We all play.
Everybody plays.
Oh, we can all be ourselves.
Right.
That's fun.
Felix the cat said.
Sick of being Brett. Felix the cat.
Felix the cat said.
Did you hear me?
Yes. Tiny Tom Thumb is a rotten little sneak. Ooh. Yesterday, when I wasn't looking, Tiny Tom took a blank in my bowl of milk. Took a blank.
I'm
my
sorry,
bowl
darling. I don't mean to do an imitation. My teeth. No, what about that? Felix the cat said, Tiny Tom Thumb is a rotten little snake.
Read it again.
One more time. Felix the cat said, Tiny Tom Thumb is a rotten little snake. Yesterday, when I wasn't looking, Tiny Tom took a blank in my bowl of milk.
Now, I hope we're not going to have it. Well, but it should.
All right.
Well, there's something better than that, but what can a girl do?
Okay. Here we go. Brett D. All. Cynthia. Felix the cat said, Tiny Tom Thumb is a rotten little sneak. Yesterday, when I wasn't looking, Tiny Tom took a blank in my bowl of milk.
I have two answers, but I'll say swim.
Swim.
Yeah.
If your second answer comes up,
I think it will.
Scream or holler or shout some crazy word. What do you say?
I also have a pure view of life. I said swim.
Oh. Swim. 3 to 1. You picked up one.
Try to avoid the toilet.
What was it? Was it squeak? Wasn't there anything? Was there anything having to do with squeak?
No. Sneak. A rotten little sneak.
Sneak. So we need something that rhymes with sneak.
No, this
right?
is not a rhymer.
Oh, okay. Tinkle.
Charles?
Is she finished with her play? Tiny Tom Tinkle.
Tiny Tom Tinkle.
TTT.
All right. Now we come to the other cast.
Intellectuals.
Yes.
I couldn't.
Yesterday when I wasn't looking, Tiny Tom took a swim in my bowl of milk.
I couldn't sink to such depths as they.
You couldn't. What do you say?
I said, now, Judge, listen, I have to explain this. Dive.
Dive.
Which is the only way you can get in to swim.
Too bad he could. Ah.
Thank you.
Pick a dive. Okay, 3-2 is the score at this moment. And now we come to Richard.
As the judge is obviously in a kind mood and nice man, please keep an open mind. Tinkle.
Well, I shall refrain from making any comment. And
here's my card if you're ever in the valley.
Yes, Paul. I will call, of course, naturally. What do you say, Fanny? You must match Fanny to stay in the game and achieve a tie, Cynthia.
Sheer pressure.
Ira, I hope so.
Yeah! Tie score!
Did you spell it correctly?
So we do end in a tie, and we'll tell you what happens when we have a tie right after we tell you about this. Here we go with a tiebreaker. Let's get rid of these lights here, push this button here, and reveal one tie-breaking question for each of you ladies, and the one who scored the most will be the winner. Gina, you may go first.
Be again, please.
You want be again? Okay. This is a tiebreaker, folks.
Okay.
At Weird Willie's picnic, when the ants came, Weird Willie blanked them. Weird Willie. Weird Willie's picnic, when the ants came, Weird Willie blanked them.
Yeah.
Now we're all ready. Gina.
I never see him.
At Weird Willie's picnic, when the ants came, Weird Willie blanked them.
Ate them?
Very good.
Hello, Aunt.
I think she came up with a very good answer, and I hope some of you have the decency to match her.
Well, I thought it was weird, so he just welcomed them. Come on in, Aunt. Be my friend, be my guest, and we'll have a wonderful time together.
Okay. He wasn't that weird. What?
Well, you know, there are a lot of very expensive gourmet shops all over this country.
Yes.
Particularly in Los Angeles and New York. And
right.
They really, truly do.
What?
Do this to ants. He chocolated them.
Chocolated them?
Yeah.
Covered them with chocolate, okay.
That's a true thing.
No doubt.
I've heard of that.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Do they have a house doctor she could see? Somebody that could help her?
House doctor?
I said salt, peppered, and ate them.
Salt, peppered, and ate them. Love your bathrobe.
Just in case she said salted. I had to cover myself.
All right. Joanne, at Weird Willie's picnic, when the ants came, Weird Willie ate them. Didn't he?
Did he?
Sure he did.
Why not?
Well, then say it.
Okay. He ate them.
All right. See how easy it is? Doesn't hurt at all, does
not
it?
Not at all. I didn't ever eat them.
Right.
Should I eat ants?
You ate ants. Yeah. Oh, I ate ants. He ate some ants. He ate them. Four out of six ain't bad, is it?
No.
You ready for yours?
Yes,
want A or B?
So.
A is what you want. Okay, okay, madam, she made a choice. There. Dumb Dora is so dumb. Not bad. When she went to a press conference, she brought along a blank. Dumb Dora is so dumb.
Oh, yeah.
When she went to a press conference, she brought along a blank.
There you go. We like the subtle ones, Dickie and I. Dickie Tony,
Sorry,
you know us. Dick Gaudier.
Well done.
Quick,
Cynthia.
Oh.
Dumb Dora is so dumb. When she went to a press conference, she brought along a blank.
An iron?
An iron.
There's a story. Oh, I'm sorry.
The gypsies. Yes.
Iron.
Iron is one. Three more to tie.
I just made the imagine. Please don't give me an argument. I hate it when you argue with me. Iron.
Love your bathrobe.
It happens to be from one of Beverly Hills' most exclusive shops.
No
well,
plugs.
Don't tell, because you'll ruin their business.
And it's a bathrobe shop.
The bath and closet shop.
I have other offers, and it's renewal time. Just keep that in mind. I'm sure that'll get to Park Avenue. I'm only kidding.
Yeah.
This is a wonderful place to be if you're healthy. Steam iron.
Steam iron. So now the score is 4-3. One more iron will tie the score for Cynthia. Two will win the game. Joanne.
Yes.
It's up to you.
It is?
Yep, she's looking for an iron.
How about Blanchard? En Espanol.
Okay.
En Inglés.
Tie score. One more iron will win the game.
I have to tell you, it did not occur to me.
It didn't.
But I wrote it.
That wins the game and come all the way across. Here we go. Now you hang around there. Don't go away. Gina, it was a pleasure to meet you, my dear.
Thank you. Thank
you're a very lovely lady, and we've got some gifts for you together with our thanks. Gina Giampetro. While we're spinning her off, we'll spin some messages just for you. Hurry back. How do you feel? Here we are. One of us is off the adhesive tape.
Oh, that's me.
That's you, yes. Where's my adhesive tape? Anyway, this lady is up here for the second time. She now has $700, but she could win over $5,000 here if things go well for her. You ready for this one now?
I'm ready.
Okay. We polled a studio audience here some time ago, and we got their best response to this. Parent blank. Remember, you get $500 if you match the answer that they gave most often. $250 for their second most popular response, and then $100 for the third. And three of our six celebrities will give you some help, if you'd like.
Fannie?
Parent Teachers Association.
That's what I thought.
PTA.
PTA.
Brett?
Parent... No, I like... Parents Magazine.
Parents Magazine.
Richard?
Present. Parent Present.
When he says present, that means an answer does not come to his mind
Very
instantly.
Good film.
Very good film?
Parent Trap. Thank you. Yeah.
Eight people saw that movie.
Which is more than eight saw your movie, if you remember. There were three people saw your film. Tell America what it was called.
No, I'm not going to tell them. They wouldn't even remember that.
Oh, yes, we would.
Let's see.
All right. I made one picture. It was
Cabinet
called...
Cabinet of Dr. Caligari. Yeah.
Let's hear it.
No, oh, I saw that. You
well, I was going to sneeze. I saw that. I did not want to sneeze while you were saying the name of your...
Just...
I promise you. Tell America.
The movie I made was called It Happened to Jane.
That's the person.
You saw it. One person sucks.
We've been looking for this
Jane?
Person.
Were you Jane?
Congratulations.
No, I wasn't Jane.
What did you think of the film?
I thought it was wonderful. It was Doris Day.
That's right.
Rod.
No, Lever, Jack Lemmon.
Jack Lemmon and Gene Rayburn.
Now, do you want your money back?
No, I want to keep my job. Oh.
Cynthia, are you ready to get on with it? You're going to have Parents Magazine, Parents Trap, or Parent Teachers Association.
I thought of Trap first, so
you
I'll
did.
Say Parents Trap. Yeah.
That's the first thing that came to your mind. Well, that's what we say
go
to do here.
Your
trust
instinct.
Your first instinct.
That's what you got to do.
Okay, let's find out if it's up there. We'll begin down at the bottom and root for this girl and see if we got it under the $100 number. PTA, all right. So far, that's one of them that the celebrities gave you. Let's see if we get under the $250 number. Parenthood.
That's a tough one.
Robbie, hey, listen, it might be
it's a gangster who has children.
This may be a good sign. I bet a nickel it's going to be there. All right, Earl, slide it.
Yeah!
That is good. Yeah. For number three. Yeah. Tough. Atta boy, Richard.
I'll apologize to my three people who cheered.
Yeah, get out. Very good. Now, listen, you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Remember, you got to match one celebrity to collect. And, of course, you will choose...
Richard, please.
Okay, back to the tape there. Here we go. Face me. It's worth $5,000. Let's all keep our fingers crossed for Cynthia Ingram. Wish her the best of luck, and this is it. Blank days. D-A-Y-S. Blank days. Okay, he's finished. Now, Cynthia, what answer do you think will match his exactly? If you come up with the right one, we give you the $5,000. Blank days.
Happy days.
Happy days. Well, we've had JJ on the show quite often here, so I suppose it's logical for her to say something like that. What do you say, Richard?
Excuse me, did you say JJ has been on the show?
Yes.
Of course, well, he could come on the show and that would have nothing to do with Happy Days.
He's not in the show.
He's well, in good time.
Oh, he's in good time.
You were that close, though.
I can't keep track of all of them.
Joel Fonz is in
the show. Oh, Happy Days is Henry Winkler.
Oh, Happy Days.
Congratulations, my dear. You now have $6,200. Cynthia, very happy lady here. Well, are you ready to carry on? You want to catch your breath here for a moment? All right, while you're taking a deep breath here, let's welcome Carlton Petrose. Here we go. $6,200 for you. How about that? Hello there, Carlton Petrose. This lady's won a lot of money. She's very happy, and she's going to celebrate her victory here by catching a few deep breaths. We'll find out about Carlton Petrose.
Well, I'm a Los Angeles postal clerk, and most of all, I'm a famous lookalike. And would you believe Red Fox?
Yes, I would. Oh, indeed, I would.
Well, you know, like I said, I've had several occasions, you know, that it came up. And one that stands out in my mind is one time I came out of my house, and there was two little girls that were around 4 years old. And they says, say mister. And I says, what do those little girls want? And they says, say mister. I says, yes. They said, are you Sanford and Son? I says, no, I'm not Sanford and Son. They said, well, you look like Sanford and Son. And then there's several other occasions. I was at the Thunderbird New Year's. And I came out.
Hold on just a second here.
Oh, wow. I'm sorry.
We've got to... No, you don't have to be sorry. We want to hear about it, Carlton. But
really?
Right now, we got to do a little business with America, and then we will hear the thing at the Thunderbird now. Don't go away, Carlton. Hang around here. We'll be back in a moment or so. Listen, you were all grand. Next week, however, these are the bodies who will be on the stage.
Yes.
Peter Isaacson, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Mary Wicks, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Clay.
Thank you for a wonderful week. You were just grand. Keep living here. Join us next time for Match Game 77. Goodbye. We'll be right back. hear your camera is on. All right, here we go. Gina. Georgie Porgy said, I kiss the girls and make them cry.
Wait a minute, wait a minute.
Wait. I want a little drinky poo.
You. Definitely
rat,
you.
Rat taste, oh. He says. All right. That's enough of that. Gina, are you ready? Okay. Georgie Porgy said, I kiss the girls and make them cry. And Horrible Hannah said, that's another thing. I kiss the boys and make them blank.
Run.
You ever heard the rhyme? Georgie Porgy? Little rhyme there? Okay, you ready? What do you say? I kiss the boys and make them...
That looks like Dr. Goodyear.
It's tough being first, yes.
Faint.
Faint. That's nothing I guess the boys make them faint. Okay, what do you say, Brett?
What do you say, Brett?
Well, this doesn't make me look too masculine, does it? If the judges are really kind, I said throw up.
Okay.
Chuck? Is she finished with her play?
Yeah. Come on, Chuck.
Yeah. Down there. And look who they matched. They matched all the so-called dummies up here.
That's right. They matched the dummies up there last time.
Yeah.
She did. And now this time they do. Now, just in case you've ever wondered, you haven't... In what it looks like, in case you sit up on the second tier, this is all you see of me, you see. You ready? Here we go.
Just a second. Maybe your glasses.
Don't wear glasses, no. No, no.
Oh, yes. Would you like to do me one more?
Yes.
Don't break them, sweetheart.
No, all right. Thanks. Oh, you're going to be Brett.
I'll
yes.
be Brett.
Oh,
wait, okay. Get all the glasses.
Yeah. Get your hands up. My club soda.
Now, are you ready for the question?
Fannie, your club soda.
Brett, you.
There's nothing I
are you
going to
be Charles, are you, Fannie? Okay.
What was the question you
wait,
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 wait a minute. You ready?
Well, George. Alice worked the stuff in this.
Georgie Porgy said.
Are we going to the motel later?
Yeah.
Don't worry, I must have a sip. Oh, that's good. 9 years.
There we go now. Georgie Porgy said, I kiss the girls and make them cry. And Horrible Hannah said, that's nothing. I kiss the boys and make them blank.
What was the question again? Is there an operative word? I must have a
will you start writing an answer?
I'm under pressure.
Come on, I'll write an answer.
I'll write an answer.
Georgie Boyd said, I kiss the girls, make them cry. And Horrible Hannah said, that's nothing. I kiss the boys and make them blank.
I can't.
In my bowl of milk.
I have two answers, but I'll say swim.
Swim.
Yeah.
If your second answer comes up.
I think it will.
Scream or holler or shout
okay.
some crazy word. What do you say?
I also have a pure view of life. I said swim.
Oh. Swim. 3-1. You picked up one.
Try to avoid the
now,
toilet.
What was it? Was it squeak? Wasn't there anything? Was there anything having to do with squeak?
No. Sneak. A rotten
oh,
little sneak.
Sneak. So we need something that rhymes with sneak.
No, this
right?
is not a rhymer.
Oh, okay. Tinkle.
Charles?
Is she finished with her play? Tiny Tom Tinkle.
Tiny Tom Tinkle.
TTT.
All right. Now we come to the other cast.
Intellectuals.
Yes.
I couldn't.
Yesterday when I wasn't looking, Tiny Tom took a swim in my bowl of milk.
I couldn't sink to such depths as they.
You couldn't. What do you say?
I said, now, Judge, listen, I have to explain this. Dive.
Dive.
Which is the only way you can get in to swim.
Too bad he could. What?
Thank you.
Take a dive. Okay, 3-2 is the score at this moment. And now we come to Richard.
As the judge is obviously in a kind mood, a nice man, please keep an open mind. Tinkle.
Well, I shall refrain from making any comment. And
here's my card if you're ever in the valley.
Yes, Paul. Paul, give us your answer. I kiss
as
the boys.
As usual, the incorrect answer.
Die. No, die really was kind of the definitive answer there. Kiss the boys and make them die. Now, Cynthia, my dear, you got a match 3 to tie, 4 to win. Who plays? Everybody plays.
Everybody plays.
Everybody plays.
Oh, we can all be ourselves.
Right.
That's fun.
Felix the cat said.
Sick of being British. Felix the cat said.
Tiny Tom Thumb is a rotten little sneak. Ooh. Yesterday, when I wasn't looking, Tiny Tom took a blank in my bowl of milk. Took a blank in my bowl of milk.
I'm sorry, darling. I don't mean to do an imitation, but I think you so much. What about that? Felix the cat said, Tiny Tom Thumb is a rotten little sneak.
Read it again.
One more time. Felix the cat said, Tiny Tom Thumb is a rotten little sneak. Yesterday, when I wasn't looking, Tiny Tom took a blank in my bowl of milk.
Now, I hope we're not going to have it.
Well, but it should.
All right.
Well, there's something better than that, but what can a girl do?
Okay. Here we go. Ready-all. Cynthia. Felix the cat said, Tiny Tom Thumb is a rotten little sneak. Yesterday, when I wasn't looking, Tiny Tom took a blank.
Get ready to match the stars. Dick Gaudier, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Plouffe, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn!
How are they? Good. How are you? Look at who's here. Aren't you a beautiful bunch?
Oh, yes.
Thank you,
You're Gene. Beautiful. You ready to play?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Well, shall we begin?
Sure.
Let's greet these two ladies, Cynthia Ingram and Gina Giampetro. Oh, all right. Now, here we are. Cynthia is our current champ. She's won a total of $600, and she's being challenged by Gina here. They've both had their first round questions, and at this moment, the score is 3-0 in favor of the challenger. You got your work cut out for you, haven't you?
I do, yes.
All right, we'll see how this game ends after we see about this. All right, here we go. Push the button, reveal our second round questions. Gina, you may have A or B.
B, please.
You want B? Okay. Here we go. She matched 3 people last time.
Who'd she
match? Well, she matched everybody in the upper tier last time.
They're always saying they're the smart kids.